And then there be a discrete electron. Discrete ni means we can calculate one by one. If there are 10 electrons, there will be 10 electrons. And then the electrons is suspend ataupun terapung in the general ball of positive charge. Macam mana nak cakap lah, macam okay, cik tunjuk gambar plum pudding. Right. Okay, macam ni. Okay, this is plum pudding. Nampak resins ataupun plum ni. It suspended ataupun diterapung. So, it proposed that this giant, the big one is an atom. And then the hitam-hitam ni adalah electrons. And then the electrons ni disuspend due to the repulsion between positively charged pudding ni. And then electron ni adalah negative. So, dia suspend bukan sebab tu lah basically. Basically, dia suspend. Okay, suspend terapung. Okay, and then okay, next, dia buat experiment basically, but I'm not sure which experiment dia buat. Okay, and then next, okay, this sampai dekat Ernest Rutherford. Okay, Ernest Rutherford ni, he did an experiment, okay, di mana, okay, the experiment ni, he used an alpha particle, which is a positively charged particle, okay. Okay, this is a positively charged particle, and then this is a gold foil. Okay, semua boleh nampak tak cikgu punya YouTube screen ni? Gold foil. Okay, gold foil. Okay, and then tadi siapa tu cakap, JJ Thompson suggested that semua partikel atom so adalah positif. Dia cakap semua atom adalah positif. Dalam atom positif tu ada elektron. Okay, so Ernest Rutherford did an experiment. He bombard lalukan alpha particle which positively charged. Tengah ni adalah gold foil. Okay, and then dia cakap kalau dia nak buktikan JJ Thompson tu betul ataupun salah. Dia kata hypothesis if JJ Thompson is right, alpha particle ni will be deflected because alpha gold nucleus is positive based on JJ Thompson. And then the alpha particle is positive. So detector ni tak akan detect pun alpha particle yang lalu. Tapi unfortunately for JJ Thompson lah, apa yang Ernest Rutherford discover adalah some of the particles will be deflected. Okay, some, but mostly the particles detected by this detector. Maksudnya alpha particle tu boleh tembus gold nucleus tu. Jadi ni proof JJ Thompson wrong lah. So basically the proof JJ Thompson wrong. Basically apa yang Ernest Rutherford discover adalah okay, dekat sekeliling it's not totally wrong lah. JJ Thompson tu ada yang dia wrong jugalah. Okay, eksperimen yang dibuat adalah gold leaf experiment. Okay, apa yang dia discover from the experiment, atom is mostly consists of a compact nucleus. Okay, dalam dekat tengah-tengah nucleus tu baru ada positively charge. And then dekat sekeliling compact nucleus tu ada negative charge. Okay, so apa yang dia propose adalah a nuclear model. Maksudnya nucleus lah, ada nucleus. Before this, siapa pun propose ada nucleus dekat tengah. There is a nucleus in the center of the atom. Okay, kita semua cakap ada electrons, negative, positive, but because of the, from Ernest Rutherford gold leaf experiment, okay, and then he proved that there is a nucleus in the center of the atom. Okay, so this is meme lah kita tengok ni. Okay, JJ Thompson devised a plum pudding model. Okay, yang ni, okay, plum pudding model. And then Rutherford did a gold leaf experiment. I'm about to end this man's whole career. So dia dah disapprove lah teori JJ Thompson. Okay, and then next after that, okay, this is a Niels Bohr. Okay, Niels Bohr ni not only propose a nuclear model juga, dia ada juga apa yang percanggahan dari segi Ernest Rutherford. Dia tak tak completely explain the Ernest Rutherford of Neutron theory tak completely explain the nucleus and then the electron. So apa yang Niels Bohr buat, dia create, dia propose that electron ni di sekeliling nucleus ni ada shells ataupun ada shells lah basically, di mana electron tu akan akan berada di sekeliling ni. Ada banyak-banyak shells, lebih pada satu, depends on type of elements. Okay, and then this this electron will be orbiting the nucleus. Dia akan berpusing-pusing macam planetary. Okay, dia Niels Bohr ni propose planetary model lah. Basically macam kita tahu, our center of universe is sun, and then this keliling sun we have the nine planets that is orbiting the sun. So for example macam, so they propose atom should be like this. Okay, electrons will be will be orbiting the nucleus of an atom. Sebab kalau di propose, kalau tak orbit, ada calculation yang dibuat, dia tunjukkan atom tu akan collapse kalau tak ada orbitals ni, tak ada tak ada shells ni. Yeah, okay, and Niels Bohr, after Niels Bohr, and then after that Ernest Rutherford block this timeline 19 something, he buat experiment. Okay, and then he discover ada proton in the nucleus of the on of an atom, sebab tu dia dapat positively. And then many experiment pun support juga the nuclear model. Okay, dia jumpa proton. And then last kali James Chadwick jumpa neutron, which is the neutral particles in this electron, in this atomic structure. Okay, so basically apa yang perlu kita tahu dalam, for example in questions exam, basically dia akan tanya je, who find what? Okay, siapa jumpa apa? Basically, dia takkan tanya tahun. Okay, dia takkan tanya tahun. So, dia akan, basically soalan akan tanya siapa yang jumpa apa, ataupun dia akan bagi a statement. This person, neutron was found. So, siapa dia yang jumpa? James Chadwick new model. So, you need to know who that person, the model that he proposed, and then what did he find? What did he found? Tu je. Okay, basically three things. Okay, but okay, this atomic model does not stop sampai James Chadwick. Okay, it's still under evolution, because we found new new knowledge, new discoveries. Okay, so basically adalah right now kalau we go into university or matriculation preview, basically we will deal with a quantum model proposed by Erwin Schrödinger. Schrödinger ni siapa Schrödinger? Dia terkenal dengan Schrödinger cat punya thought, ataupun dia punya thought experiment. Okay, boleh Google Schrödinger cat. Okay, quantum model ni, okay, basically apa? Dia involve quantum mechanics. Okay, yang tadi ni, before this, okay, J.J. Thomson, Ernest Rutherford, semua ni adalah classical punya mechanics, okay, classical mechanics. But sampai dekat Niels Bohr, okay, they still involve a little bit of quantum mechanics. So, we call it as semi-classical nuclear model. Sebab half of dia punya understanding is from a classical model, and then half is includes quantum mechanics. And then sampai dekat Ernest Rutherford, and then James Chadwick, and then sampai dekat Schrödinger and Heisenberg, dia akan dapat quantum model. Okay, quantum model, this is quantum model. So but it's difficult untuk lukis. Basically apa yang dia cakap bila this purple merah ni adalah dia propose electron is not, kita tak boleh cari electron tu satu-satu, right? We cannot detect one by one electrons. We can detect guna wave ataupun basically wave function lah, basically wave graph. So dekat area sini adalah the probability of paling tinggi untuk kita jumpa electron dekat orbital. Don't worry, we'll go deeper later. Okay, so and then okay, this is the memes involving. Oh, saya tak keluar. Lama. Involving the discovery of atom saja. Okay, don't worry, tak keluar tak apa. Alright. Okay, so today, okay, we are going to learn. Tadi tu kita dah belajar historical development. Okay, and then next we're going to learn how to write and draw the atomic structure and then the electron arrangement. Okay, boleh buka buku teks, muka surat 35. Okay, basically, kita kena ada satu cara, must a method to lukis or to tulis, to draw or to write. Untuk tunjukkan the model of electrons. Okay, apa yang selalu kita guna adalah electron arrangement. Okay, belah kiri ni. The difference between electron and arrangement and atomic structure dia just in the nucleus. Okay, in the nucleus for electron arrangement we have the element. For example, in this example is Al, but in the atomic structure it has the number of protons dan the number of neutrons. But we basically we just deal with this, the electron arrangement. Okay, this is the diagram, cara kita lukis. Okay, don't worry, we go later. Okay, okay. Ada dua, I don't want to say method. Two types. Dua jenis lah, okay. How do we represent an atom? Okay, number satu, we draw. And then number two is we write. Okay. Now, untuk draw, basically, apa yang kita boleh lukis adalah, nanti cikgu akan tunjuk cara cikgu nak lukis. The first thing is the in the middle is the nucleus. We just write the element symbol. Okay, for example, tadi aluminium, we just write aluminium. Okay, and then, okay, this is the first ring ataupun the shell 1, 2, 3. Okay, but ada dia punya rule dia. Okay, for the first electron shell, the maximum number of electrons that we can draw is only 2. Maximum is only 2. Okay, and then for the next shell is 8, and then the next shell, the third shell, is maximum is 18. Okay, nanti cikgu akan bagi tahu macam mana kita nak tahu berapa banyak shells yang dia ada and then berapa banyak electrons yang dia ada. Okay, this the outer shell ni, okay, depends on the ni lah elements. Kalau dia ada 4 shell, dia shell number 4 lah. Kalau dia ada 5 shell, dia shell number 5. The outer shell ni we call as the valence shell. Okay, valence shell. And then the electrons yang ada dekat valence shells ni we call as the valence electrons. Okay, the now valence electron ataupun electron paling luar. Okay, the valence electron ni akan involve, basically electrons ni akan involve in chemical reaction, this valence electrons. Okay. And then okay, we go, okay, cikgu tunjuk macam mana kita nak lukis. Alright. Okay, can everyone see this? Okay, for example, kita ada paling senang dulu cikgu akan lukis adalah hydrogen. Okay, we have hydrogen. Okay, number one, we draw hydrogen. Okay, write H, to write H. Okay, we draw the first electron shell. Okay, and then we know that hydrogen only have one electron. So just draw one. It can be a cross ataupun dot macam ni lah. Tapi kena lukis sama lah basically. Kalau kita lukis dot, kena lukis dot. Kalau tulis cross, kena lukis cross. This is the draw lah, the representation, our drawing. But kalau kita nak tulis, kita tulis apa? One je macam tu, electron arrangement. Okay, next kita pergi yang susah sikit. Sekejap, cikgu check periodic table. Okay, cikgu pergi untuk argon. Okay, argon. Argon ada 18. Okay. Sekejap. Oops. Okay, argon 18 electron. So, from our rules tadi tu untuk lukis, kita must maximum number of electrons yang boleh ada untuk first shell is 2 and then 8 and then 18. Okay, so based on 18 ni, apa yang kita boleh tulis adalah 2, okay, and then next is 8. So kita dah ada 10 electrons, and then another thing is 8. So 8, 2 tambah 8, 8, 8 tambah 10, 8 tambah 8, 10 tambah 8, 18. Okay, so dah cukup electrons yang ada. So macam mana kita nak draw dia pula? Kita draw argon, AR, kita draw AR. Then kita lukis first shell dulu. Okay, lukis cross, 1, 2. And then next shell. We draw 8, okay 8. Kita tengok cara cikgu lukis yang mana. The number of electrons ni, okay, next shell ni basically ni nak, just nak bagi dia nampak teratur, okay. But in real life, the electrons bukan berada macam ni. Dia just to be nampak teratur, senang nak kira. So must be 2, 2, okay. Basically dekat-dekat, and then dekat at every corner. Not corner lah, every edge lah. And then lastly is 8. And then we will get 18. Okay, remember kalau kita nak write secara tulisan, tulis number of electrons. So this is first shell, second shell and then third shell. Okay, must be, kena ada dot. 2.8.8. This is the electron arrangement. This one secara tulisan, secara written. Then this is secara what we call it, secara lukisan. Okay, we go back to hydrogen. Okay, we learn that kalau this is kalau untuk atom yang neutral. Okay, but what happen kalau it donates or it receive electrons? Okay, bila dia jadi ion. Okay, for example H, okay, H hydrogen, it can donates an electrons. So bila dia donates, the charge will be positive. Okay, so kalau kita nak lukis adalah H. Oh, sorry. H. Okay, since it will donate one electron, and then dia ada cuma satu elektron saja, so dia tak ada elektron pun dalam tu. And then kita buat satu ni, kotak kecil ni. Okay, macam bracket, square bracket. Then we put the positive charge here. Okay, maksudnya dia dah donate one elektron. Tetapi, okay, kalau kita buat NaCl, okay, cikgu pergi NaCl, HCl lah, tak nak NaCl. HCl. Okay, H akan jadi H plus, Cl akan jadi Cl minus. Okay, untuk untuk elektron ni, basically kita nak senang, we just draw the valence electrons, a valence shell only. Okay, kalau H tadi, okay, H tadi macam ni plus. Okay, untuk Cl pula, okay, Cl cikgu lukis valence electron saja. Valence electron Cl untuk chlorine atom ada 7. So we draw the 7 dulu. Okay, right now we have 7. Okay, but from H plus we receive one electron from H. Okay, jadi tadi kita lukis electron untuk H, we draw as a cross. Okay, and then we donates H, donates one electron to Cl. Okay, this is, okay, kita lukis cross to represent that the electrons that yang dah didonate from H. And then, don't forget the charge. Yes?
The CL without the H is unstable.
Yes. Therefore, in our environment, CL will exist as CL2, not CL. And then that's why it's unstable.
Okay.
Okay, right now we deal with atoms. We deal with atoms basically, okay? So basically, that's why other atoms that can exist as themselves, okay? Satu atom saja, for example, in group 1 and group 18, okay, H, Na, He, but kalau untuk elements yang Cl, Cl apa lagi? Cl, nitrogen, okay? In our room temperature, it can exist as Cl. It only exists as a molecule, O2, Cl2, okay? Because it is not stable. Alright, okay. Okay. From our electron arrangement, we can conclude a relationship between atomic structure and the periodic table. Okay, for this, okay, see this first. Group number, okay, group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, until 18, is equal to the number of valence electrons. Okay, we go to the periodic table. Okay, for example, okay, this is group, the column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, until 18. Group 1, hydrogen, the number of electrons is 1. Okay, let us check. Betul ke tak? The number of valence electrons. Mana cikgu lukis tadi? Okay. Hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen is 1. 1 electron. And then is in group 1. So it means that the number of valence electrons yang H ada is only 1 based on the periodic table. Group 1 will only have 1 electron, add valence electrons. Okay, we go for lithium. Okay, lithium pula. Okay, it say that in lithium, okay, lithium, the electron number is 3. Okay, 3. Okay, but from the electron arrangement structure, the maximum number of first shell is 2. Okay, and then the maximum number of electron in second shell is 8. Okay, but it only have 3 electrons. So, we write 2.1. So, betul lah. In group 1, the number of valence electrons is 1. Valence electron, the outermost shell. If we gonna draw it, Li, we draw 2. And then, okay, 3. We got 3 electrons and 1 valence electron. This is the valence electrons. Okay, we go to... okay, but for group 3 until group 12, okay, this is a transition metal. Okay, from scandium until zinc, okay, this kotak, this is a transition metal. So, transition metal is not depends on the number of ni. It is invalid, maksudnya, because sometimes, for example, palladium. Okay, palladium, the number of valence electron is 10. Okay, but dekat nickel ni, atas dia pula, the valence electron is 2. Sebab dia, basically, it will deals with quantum model because it need the lowest energy field electrons, orbitals. Sebab it has more than 3. Okay, satu lagi because it has more than 3 shell. And then dia punya, dia punya structure, atomic structure will be quite different lah basically. Untuk level SPM, we gonna learn from element 1 until element 20 only, from hydrogen to calcium. Okay, but I will introduce lah, okay, transition metals nanti and then the extra one. Okay, next, okay, you said that invalid for transition metal group 3 until group 12. Okay, untuk group 13, okay, tadi cikgu cakap tadi okey cuma cakap okey kalau group group 1 valence electron valence electrons mesti ada 1 kan. So group 13 the number of valence electron must be 13 juga ke? It's not really 13, basically it's can be 3 or 13, okay, for boron. Boron ada 3, okay, boron. Draw boron dulu. Okay, boron 5 electrons, so it can be 2, 3. So the number of valence electrons is 3. But untuk aluminium, say 13. 2, 3, 8. 3. So 3 juga 13. Okay, basically it's not 13 lah, 3. Okay, the 3 valence electrons, not 13. Okay, and then for group 14 is 4 valence electron, 15 5 valence electron, 16 6, and then 17 7, and then 18 8 valence electron. So not 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 lah. Okay, 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and then for the next one is period number. Period is the row. Okay, row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tu. Yang ke bawah tu. Okay, dalam ni dia cakap period number is equal to the total number of electron shells. Okay, kalau satu, okay, period 1, it only have one shell. Betul ke tak? Okay, kita pergi. Tadi untuk hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen tadi ada group 1 and period 1. So it only have one valence electrons and valence shell. Betul ke tak? Okay, betul. Kita tengok ada satu. Satu valence shell saja. Kita proof juga untuk okay, lithium. Lithium group 1 but it's in period 2. Betul tak? Okay, kita ada dua period dekat sini. Satu. Two. So it means that it has two electron shell. Okay, two electron shell and so on. Sambahlah sampai 7, it will have 7 shell. Okay, for example, okay, ramai yang confused bila tengok yang ni, lanthanides ni. Okay, lanthanides ni is in group 6 and group 7. Okay, dia bukan group 8 or 9. Okay, group 6 and 7 and it will be in the group 3, transition metal ni. We just expand this kotak because kalau kita letak satu-satu tu banyak, okay, the transition metal ni and then the periodic table akan jadi lagi besar. So ni just expand je kat bawah. So bukan bermaksud lanthanum ni group 4, okay, lanthanum ni bukan group 4, it's still group 3 in period 6. Sama juga dengan lithium ni semua, okay. Sebab dia between 57 and 71. In 72 baru period period 6 and group 4. Ni baru hafnium, okay. So lanthanum ni bukan group bukan group 4. Group 3. All of this kat bawah ni adalah group 3. Group 3 period 6 and period 7. Okay? Okay, next we will do okay classwork. Kita okay, akan ada homework untuk hari ni but I need you to do classwork. Okay, kena siapkan sekarang and then boleh submit dekat Google Classroom. Okay, dekat Google Classroom nanti tak gambar, submit dekat sini. Classwork for 21 and 22 Jun. Okay, ada dua task. Okay, number one, I need you to do test yourself 2.3. Okay, textbook page 36. Write the answer terus. Okay, tak payah salin soalan. On your writing book, tulis tarikh and then test yourself 2.3, okay, write terus dia punya jawapan. And then for number 2 ni, okay, pick 3 elements, okay, from our first 20 tu, 1 sampai, tapi jangan yang cikgu dah buat, lithium, helium, aluminium, apa lagi, lithium, helium, aluminium yang cikgu dah lukis ni, chlorine, okay, dengan semua group 18 H E N E N R tak boleh pick. Okay, so kena write, draw and write the electron arrangement for 3 out of the first 20 boleh pilih calcium, magnesium. Okay, and then tetapi apa soalan ni cakap atoms and ions. Okay, atoms pun and ions kena lukis. Atoms yang ni, ni untuk atoms, maksud dia dia positif, tak ada charge. Okay, ni macam ni, hydrogen. Kalau untuk ion, yang ni. Kita kena lukis bracket dia. Okay, boleh buat sekarang. Okay, buat sekarang. And then, cikgu still ada dekat atas, dekat Google Meet ni. Kalau tak faham soalan, boleh tanya cikgu terus. Okay, do it now.
Teacher, I don't understand how to draw the...
How to draw, okay. First, to draw the electron arrangement, okay, first, we must know the location of the elements in the periodic table, okay? Wait. Okay. First, to draw, first step. Okay, first step. The location, tak, not location lah basically. The location is for cheat lah. Not cheat lah, for, okay, number first, we know the electron. The electron first, the electron number, total of electron. Okay, the electron. Okay, for example, okay, you want to draw neon. Okay, neon. Okay, neon, we know that we have 10 electrons. Okay, 10 electrons, neon. 10 electrons. Okay, 10 electrons we know. Okay, draw and write is the same, okay? Draw, okay, first to know the atomic structure, the electron arrangement. This is the rule, okay, the rule. The rule is first shell, maximum is only 2 electrons. And then second shell.
Teacher, what is neon?
Neon is electron. Sorry, it's atom. Sorry, it's element in the periodic table. This group 18, period 2. The electron number is 10. Okay, second shell, the max is 8. Third shell, max is 18. Okay, from this, okay, we know that you can write as neon ada 10 electrons. Okay, 10 electrons. So, first shell we write as 2 dulu. 2, okay, dot. Max is 8. Right, 8. So, 8 plus 2 is already 10. So, it's dah lengkap lah. Dah lengkap. And then, the other rules yang kita boleh tahu adalah from the periodic table, a group will show the number of valence electrons. And then, period will show number of shells.
What is valence electrons?
Valence electron is the electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, for example, neon, okay, we have only 2 shell, first shell and second shell. Write as neon. Okay, we draw 2 electron first shell, then 8 electrons. Okay, the valence electrons, okay, how do we know the valence, how many valence electrons or how many shells that an atom has? Okay, valence electrons we will depends on the group number. In group 1 you have 1 valence electrons, group 2 2 valence electrons, okay, group 3 and 12 kita takkan belajar, no, abaikan dulu 3 to 12, okay. Group 13, 3 electrons, 14, 4, 15, 5, 16, 6, 17, 7, 18, 8. Okay, to the number of valence electrons. valence electron is the number of electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, and then for the period 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is the number of shells that the atom can have. Okay, for example, in lithium, it's in group 2. So the maximum of shells that lithium can has is 2 electrons only. But we see that it's in group 1. So in group 1, it means that the valence electron that lithium can has is 1. Okay, for beryllium, it can have 2 electron shells and 2 valence electron. Sorry, 2 valence electron and 2 shells. Okay, boleh tak? Can you understand it?
Jadi cikgu, kan tadi cikgu ada lukis hidrogen yang dia donate tu kan? Yang cikgu ada lukis Cl, klorin tu, cikgu lukis outer dia ke?
Yang ni cikgu lukis outer dia saja. Untuk senang kan, sebab dia banyak kan nanti kan. Untuk ion, just lukis dia punya outer saja. This is outer.
Jadi, cikgu tulis 7 tu sebab dia dalam grup 17.
Yes, bila dalam grup 17, Cl cuma ada 7 elektron saja. Bukan 7 elektron saja, 7 outermost elektron, 7 valence elektron.
Nanti dalam tu kena lukis tak?
Dalam ni tak payah lukis lah sebab banyak. Tapi kalau untuk draw untuk atom, untuk atom kena lukis.
Okay, cikgu.
Untuk ion macam ni kan, untuk ion kita nak senangkan dia, kita tak nak crowded, kita lukis valence electron saja. Ni tak apa, ini nanti kita akan learn later dalam ionic bonding. Untuk sekarang ni cikgu nak semua lukis je dulu. Tapi ni dalam bentuk ni lah, bentuk ion. Alright, boleh lukis.
Yang kurungan tu apa cikgu? Yang luar bulatan tu.
Nak menunjukkan dia dah terima luar bulatan ni memang kena ada sebab kita nak kita nak represented as an ion, sebagai sebuah ion. Kalau ada bracket ni bermaksud ni adalah ion. And then kita kena tulis dia punya charge, positif ataupun negatif.
Okay, baik cikgu. Cikgu, balance elektron tu yang mana dalam periodic table?
Group, kita tengok group. Kalau satu, dia ada satu je valence elektron. Ni satu, dua, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, semua ikut ni. Satu valence elektron, dua valence elektron. Dekat bawah 13, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yang group 3 sampai 12 ni kita abaikan dulu.
Oh, okay, baik cikgu.
Okay, next, siapa lagi nak tanya?
Teacher, just now you said is how to write it. You didn't say how to draw.
Oh, okay. How to draw? Okay. Draw. Okay, this dah draw. Okay, right? We just write it as 2.8 number of electrons in first shell and second shell. Okay, and then how to draw it? Sekejap. Change color. Okay, we write the atom, the element symbol in the middle. For example, in neon, the symbol is Ne. You write Ne, this one. And then we draw the first shell, and then we draw the electrons. The dots is the electrons. 1, 2, okay. It must be like opposite each other supaya senang nak nampak lah, easy for us to see. Because it's more in a regular order lah basically. And then for the second shell is 8, so we draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, do the second question first lah. Okay, first question tu yang test yourself ni boleh buat habis kelas. Okay, do yang ni dulu ni. Draw ni. Ini kena buat dulu. Cikgu nak tahu macam mana semua lukis. Draw and write the electron arrangement for atoms and ion for 3 out of.
Teacher, where can we choose from?
Sorry?
Where can we choose from?
From the periodic tables.
You said only 20.
First 20 elements. 1, 220, because after 21 until 27, it become complicated.
You're like, how to choose?
How to choose? Depends on yourself. No, but you cannot choose hydrogen,
no, like lithium. Which one? 20.
You cannot choose, let me, okay. Yeah, 1 until 20. Pick 3. Cannot choose lithium, hydrogen, and aluminium. Because I already show the example. And then this helium.
I mean, how to count the first 20?
From the periodic table, we see the number of electrons. Okay. Can you see the number of electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Start with hydrogen is 1. Okay. He is 2. Okay, we read the proton number. Proton number is equal to electron number. We choose from hydrogen until calcium. You can
mean, you mean 1, 2, 3 to 20.
Sorry, what?
You mean the electron number 1, 2, 3 to 20.
Yes, proton number, yes. I choose the first 20 elements. Okay, from the periodic table, from hydrogen until calcium. Okay. Hydrogen is proton number is 1, and then calcium is 20. So pick 3 elements from this first 20 electrons, except lithium, hydrogen, aluminium, helium, neon, and argon. This file lah, because I already shown the example.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, draw first lah. Okay, I need you to do the second question first. Test yourself ni, can do later. Okay, anyone has problem? Kepala kena lukis. Lukis ni lah. Electron arrangement for atoms and ions. Okay, lukis ni, electrons arrangement. Pilih satu, okay, from 20 elements in the periodic table, pilih 3. Kemudian lukis. Lukis yang macam cikgu lukis tadi tu. Lukis
dan bulat tulis. Bulat kata ada simbol kat dalam tu cikgu.
Ada simbol kat dalam tu. Lukis yang ni, kemudian tulis dia punya tulisan dia. Kita boleh buat dua, sama ada lukis ataupun tulis, okay. Dia punya arrangement dia. So, cikgu nak lukis dan tulis.
Cuma nak tahu dia punya arrangement tu.
Kan cikgu dah cakap tadi, based on electron number, based on electrons, okay, kita tengok tadi ni. Kita tengok dalam periodic table, kena tahu based on periodic table, kita tengok electron number dia. Okay, neon ada 10 elektron, okay. Ada 10 kat sini. Jadi apa rule dia adalah shell pertama kita kena maksimum kita boleh letak 2 saja electrons. And then for second shell maksimum 8, dan third shell maksimum 18. Jadi kita tulis dulu, kita tulis dulu nak senang, kita tulis first shell 2 electrons, second shell ada 8. Jadi 2 tambah 8 dah 10 elektron. Jadi dah cukup lah 10 elektron yang dia ada. Kemudian bila nak lukis, okay, ni shell dia. Okay, nombor 1 kita tulis Ne, kita tulis dia punya simbol. Nombor 2 kita lukis lah dia punya elektron dia macam dot ni. Kita boleh dot ataupun kita cross kan. Kita ada 2 ni, 1, 2, okay. First shell, shell yang pertama. Kemudian shell yang kedua adalah kita ada 8 kat sini, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Cikgu, kalau dia lebih daripada 10, jadi kena buat third share sekali lah.
Ya, yeah, betul. Lebih daripada 10 kena third share sekali. Tapi kata macam kita tadi kan cikgu cakap hidrogen ada satu je kan, hidrogen. Kita lukis satu je lah. Kita macam tadi ni, hidrogen kita nak satu shell saja sebab dia cuma ada satu je. Tetapi lithium ni ada 3, so dia dah lebih daripada 2. Lithium ada 3, dia lebih daripada 2, jadi kita kena tambah satu lagi shell. Kalau helium ada 2 saja, helium 2, kita lukis satu shell saja, 2. 1, 2, tu dia He. Macam tu. Tapi ingat cikgu suruh minta tulis dalam bentuk atoms, yang tadi ni stable adalah atoms. Kemudian kita cikgu nak dalam bentuk ion. Okay, ion tu bila dia ada charge. Contoh yang macam yang ni. Okay, contohnya macam hidrogen ni, dia bercharge positif sebab dia dah dermakan satu elektron. Jadi dia dah tak ada elektron lah dalam shell dia. Dia tulis H. Lukis shell saja kosong. Tapi buat bracket, square bracket ni, kita memang buat simbol plus. Bermaksud dia dah dermakan satu elektron. Untuk yang menerima elektron pula, contohnya, apa dia?
Kalau ke simbol pangkah boleh juga?
Boleh, sama ada cross ataupun pangkah. Boleh, tapi jangan campur-campurkan. Kalau untuk yang atom stable, kita tak boleh campur. Tapi bila ion yang selalunya yang dah menerima elektron, kita boleh letak pangkah, satu pangkah, kita boleh letak yang asal dia pangkah ke ataupun cross, pangkah ke ataupun dots, dan yang menerima tu, yang didapat daripada atom lain pula tu dalam bentuk lain, supaya kita boleh tahu atom tu, elektron tu asal pada mana. Maksudnya kita tahulah dia dah didermakan. Contohnya macam Cl ni, okay, kita tengok original yang dia ada adalah dot. Okay, dot satu dia, dia ada 7. Tetapi dia dah terima satu elektron pada H. Dia akan ni, ni pangkah ni. Ni nak tunjukkan dia dah terima satu elektron daripada H. Kemudian kita buat bracket square dan kita letak negatif sebagai charge dia.
Cikgu. Macam mana nak tahu dia positif atau negatif?
Kita tengok, kalau dia dermakan elektron, dia positif lah. Kalau dia menerima elektron, dia akan negatif. Macam mana nak tahu adalah untuk ion. Ion ni basically adalah atom yang telah menerima. Atom that is already received or donate electrons. Okay. Untuk selalunya, yang akan positif adalah group 1, group 2, group 4, group 13, group 14. Okay, macam mana kita nak tahu bila dia ada lebih electrons? Okay, the number of maximum electron yang kita nak adalah sweet number adalah 8. Okay, 8. Contohnya macam 8 ataupun 2. Okay, 8 ataupun 2. Okay, and then yang akan terima elektron akan negatif selalu adalah nitrogen. Bukan, group 15 sampai 17. 15 sampai 17. Okay, the sweet number that we want ialah 2 ataupun 8, baru dia stable. Okay, for example, untuk chlorine ni. Chlorine ni kita tahu dia ada, dia in group 17, so dia mesti ada berapa valence electron? Group 17. 17 ke berapa? Kita tengok balik. Berapa valence electron yang chlorine mesti ada? Okay, tengok balik cikgu cakap ni satu, dua. Okay, grup satu mesti ada satu, grup dua mesti ada dua. Tapi grup 13 sampai 17, dia bukan ada 13, dia ada 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Grup 17 ada 7, grup 16 ada 16, grup 15 ada 15, grup 14 ada 14, grup 13 ada 13. Grup 14 ada 4, grup 13 ada 3. So, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Jadi, in group Cl, klorin adalah dalam grup 7. Okay, jadi dia cuma ada 7 valence electrons. Okay, ingat sweet number is either 2 ataupun 8. So, in this case, mana lagi senang? Untuk jadi 7, untuk jadi 2 ke atau untuk jadi 8? Sama dia kena buang 5 electrons ataupun diterima 1 electron. Mana lagi senang?
Buang.
Kenapa?
Ambil.
Kita nak yang nombor paling sikit sebab dia nak lowest energy. Jadi apa yang jadi adalah dia terima je satu elektron. Tu paling senang. Dia terima satu je daripada terima satu daripada terima satu instead of buang lima. Jadi bila dia dah terima, okay, dia akan jadi negatif lah sebab dia terima. So apa yang group yang 15 sampai group 17 basically semua akan menerima elektron. Jadi dia akan bercas negatif. For example, oksigen ni, dia dalam group 16. So, how many valence electrons dia ada?
16. 6.
Jadi, berapa elektron yang diperlukan untuk dia jadi stable? Okay, sweet number berapa? 6 ke 2? 8 ke 2?
Sweet number.
Okay, cikgu cakap, untuk electrons stable, electrons yang di electrons yang perlu ada dalam suatu atom untuk dia stable, okay, it must be a sweet number yang dia nak ialah 2 ataupun 8, okay, duplet or octet, okay. Selalu untuk 2, untuk hydrogen, lithium, helium, okay. Tetapi untuk yang lebih daripada 3 lah basically, lebih daripada 3 ataupun lebih lebih daripada 5 lah. Okay, 5 ke 6 something macam tu, dia nak 8. Dia nak valence electron dia nak ada 8. Okay, jadi untuk oksigen ni, kita tahu tadi valence electrons yang dia ada adalah 6. Okay, jadi untuk jadi 8 dia perlukan berapa lagi elektron? Macam mana cuba? Oksigen ada group 16, so dia ada 6 electron, 6 valence electrons. Untuk jadi stable, you must receive how many
two.
Electrons?
2.
Untuk jadi?
16.
Ha? Untuk jadi berapa? Untuk berapa electrons yang dia kena ada?
8.
8. Okay. Kita ingat dia nak 2 ataupun 8 saja. 2 ataupun 8. Contohnya macam lithium ada 3 valence electron, ada 2 valence electron, bukan 2, ada 1 valence electrons. Okay, lithium ada 1 valence electron untuk group 1. Jadi dia nak derma ke dia nak terima elektron? Mana yang lagi senang?
Derma.
Dia nak jadi 2 ke ataupun dia nak jadi, okay, dia terima. Dia nak jadi 2 ke ataupun dia jadi 8? Okay, macam ni lah cerita. Yuk. Okay, tak apa. Untuk masa sekarang ni nanti lukis yang atom saja. Ion tak perlukan lagi. Lukis atom ni. Sebab ion ni nanti kita akan masuk bonding.
Teacher.
Atom yang stable. Yes?
Teacher. So, have 3 rings. The first ring is 2 electron. Second is 8. Third one is 18.
Maximum.
Yes, maximum is 18. Mm-hmm. But for those atoms that more than this have more rings?
Yes, has more rings. For example, yang ada 100 electrons, okay? Depends on this ni, on this period, okay? For example, francium, it has 87 electrons, okay? But from this, we know that row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This row period means period 7, it will have 7 ring ataupun 7 shells. For period 1, 1 shells ataupun 1 ring saja.
But how do we know how many electrons must be in the ring?
Okay, it depends on the number of electrons lah. Okay, for example tadi sodium, okay. Tak nak sodium, we write as argon ataupun neon, argon lah, argon. Okay, argon. Wait, my pen is not working. Argon. Okay, how many electrons?
18.
Okay, 18. So, kita write dulu. Macam mana kita nak tulis? Apa yang kita tulis dulu?
2.
2 and then
8.
Cikgu, dia memang kena 2 lah cikgu.
Yes, apa-apa start dulu dengan 2. 8 and then
10.
10 or 2.
8.
Should be 8 and 2. Okay, ni basically dia involve quantum model because it's not 288. Sorry.
Cikgu, dia mula je dengan 2 lepas tu tak kena tak nombor berapa.
Mesti mula dengan 2. Kecuali hydrogen. Hydrogen 1. Okay, argon 18. Should be 2. 8 and then 8. Cukup lah 18. So cara paling senang kita nak tahu about how many valence electron that argon should have and then how many shells that argon should have. Okay, we go first to dia punya group. Okay, apa dia? Yishao?
So the 4th, 5th and 6th, 7 periods is much more confusing.
Yes, much more confusing.
Okay.
Okay.
That you didn't teach yet.
Yes. We only for period 4, we only learn until calcium only. Okay. Calcium.
Hmm.
Okay. The formula is macam mana kita nak tahu how many valence electron on how many shells that we should draw or write. Okay. First, we refer to the period dulu. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. For example, in argon tadi, argon is in period 3. Okay, period 3. So, it must have 3 shells. Okay, 3 shells only. Cannot be 4, cannot be 2, cannot be 1. Only 3 shells. Okay, and then from the group, okay, group, we can know the valence electron number. Okay, since argon is in group 18, the valence electron will be 8. Okay, not 18, 8. Sama juga dengan 13. From 13 until 18, the number of electron is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, not 13, 14, 15. Okay, ni salah. Not 13, 14. So, only 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Okay, so from our ni, kita lukis. Period 3. Oh. Period 3. So, 3 shell. And then, group 8. 18. So, 8 valence electron. Okay. Boleh faham tak? Okay, complete this. The deadline is before our next class. Will be on Wednesday. Okay, complete this. Boleh tanya juga cikgu nanti.
Teacher, one more. What is standard representation?
Okay, standard representation yang ni kita belajar. A, Z, X. Macam ni. Okay, for example, argon. I'm not sure is Z, X or X, Z. Let me check first. Okay, X is the element A and then Z. This is a standard representation. Okay, A is the nucleon number, Z is the proton number. For example, just terbalik daripada periodic table. Okay, periodic table the 18 ke atas, tapi untuk standard representation 18 is here, the number of protons. Okay, and then the number of nucleon, which is 36. Let me check. Number 40 akan ada kat atas the nucleon number. This is the standard representation. In periodic table, we will see 1840. This is how we write in periodic table. But as a standard representation, if we want to write it on a paper ataupun in a journal or a scientific article, you must write it as AR 40 18. Okay. Okay, you got class at 11 kan? Okay, I'm gonna end this class right now. Okay, I will share.
Cikgu.
Ya, apa dia?
Hajar ini cuma tulis dia punya nombor elektron tu je kah?
Ah, okay, kerja ini ada dua. Okay, buat test yourself 2.3, textbook page 36. And then draw and write the electron arrangement for atoms. Okay, atoms saya not ions. Ions tunggu dulu. Sebab still tak faham lagi. Ions apa? Yang dah buat tak apa. Yang dah buat tak apa. Pilih 3 daripada first 20 elements. Okay, 1 sampai 20 tu. Pilih 3. Kecuali ni. H-E, N-E, A-R. Okay, yang ni. Okay. Tak boleh sebab cikgu dah tunjuk. Tak cik lah. Nanti cikgu okay. Screenshot ni. Kerja hari ni. Boleh postkan nanti kerja dekat dalam Google Classroom. Cikgu dah upload dekat sini. Chapter 2. Classwork for 21 and 32 June. Deadline before Wednesday lah. On Wednesday. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, kalau tak ada questions. Cikgu tangguhkan kelas dulu. Kita akan sambung hari Rabu. Alright, okay. Cikgu check. Alright, okay. Get ready untuk masuk kelas physics, okay? Alright, thank you semua.
Thank you, bye.
Thank you, cikgu. Assalamualaikum.
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Assalamualaikum.